5 to 7 ओक। Good afternoon students, welcome to your English class. Today we would proceed with English grammar. Okay, the chapter that we had started was non-finite verbs. So one of you please tell me till which exercise we have done. Any question related to the exams, okay, I will be answering towards the end of the class. Now let us study a little bit. I will keep 10 minutes for answering your queries, for any kind of doubts you might have regarding the PT1 exam, okay. So for now let us start studying non-finite verbs. I think we have completed till exercise number G. No, till exercise number F we have completed. We will begin from exercise number G. All right. Up to exercise G or from exercise G we will start. From G we will start, yes, correct. So exercise G we will begin, page number 59, everybody open. Now we are going to use non-finite verb infinitive to make the sentences compact. To make the sentence compact, that means short. So suppose the sentence is there, say he was the only performer who knew how to sing. Okay, who knew how to sing. Now this sentence can be shortened to make it compact. We can change the sentences. He was the only performer to know how to sing. Okay, this one doesn't become very compact, but sentences we can make them very very compact. Okay, so look at exercise number G, all of you. Look at exercise number G. We are going to solve it in the copy. Okay, so exercise G number 1 is written. Number 2, Akshat was the only boy who brought a gift for Samarth. It will be Akshat was the only boy to bring a gift for Samarth. Number 3, Pradeep was the only candidate who could qualify for the boxing championship. Pradeep was the only candidate to qualify for. We have completed this exercise. Okay, so we will begin from H to qualify for the boxing championship. Okay, so let us begin from H. I asked you in the beginning. So now we are going to use infinitives to join sentences. Okay. Infinitives to join sentences. Suppose he collects old antique clocks. He loves it. These two sentences are there. He collects antique clocks. He loves it. We can combine these two sentences by using infinitive. He loves to collect antique clocks. Okay. So we see that one of the finite verbs in the sentence, first sentence, is changed into a infinitive, an infinitive. Okay. Now we are going to begin the exercise. How we can join two sentences using the infinitive two. Okay, two infinitive. Exercise H, we will start, right? Or did we complete exercise H also? Did we complete exercise H? Give me a definitive answer. For me it is difficult because we have three sections of class 7 and in each of the sections some other part is, that means the progress is not the same for all the classes. We will start from H. Thank you, Shampurna. Let us begin this class then. Number 1, you can borrow the paint box, you need the artist's permission. So, the answer is very easy. You need the artist's permission to borrow the paint box. Okay. Write in copy. Number 2, Shaptorshi has written all the answers, I think. Match your answers from the one which I am doing, okay. Annesha has also written, Aniruddha has written one. Whatever you have written, you have to match the answer with the one we are doing in class. Don't expect me to see all your individuals because you are giving in total. I think some of them are wrong, okay. So, please check your answers from the board. The woman, but it's very good of you to try writing the answers on your own. I applaud it. The woman is very old, she cannot talk properly. The woman is too old to talk properly, or the woman is very old to talk properly. That is also correct. Number 3, all the citizens should pay their taxes. The government expects this of all the citizens. The government expects all the citizens to pay their taxes. Number 4, all the students must participate in the sports day function. The principal expects this of all the students. The principal expects all the students to participate in the sports day function. Please check your answers, Aniruddha. Number 5, you should return the books you borrowed. I expect you to return the books you borrowed. Okay, so we are going to stop over here. Now I am going to tell you something about the PT1 exam. Have you all completed exercise 8? Yes, I am giving. Anisha has a question. Answer of nouns, exercise A, page 13. Yeah. So, can I give the answers verbally? Will you follow? First of all, let me give you the general idea of the exam. Then, whatever specific confusion you have, you can ask me. So, PT1 exam will be of MCQ types. 20 questions will be there in English, containing each 1 marks. Okay, so 20 marks question will be there. It will be an MCQ type question, so expect inside questions from the book. Even in grammar, don't just do the exercise, but do all the things which are mentioned in the book. Okay, so the syllabus is grammar chapter 1, 2, and 21, that is question tags. Main text, 3 questions. And squirrel. Supplementary. The tiny teacher. Okay, this is all about your exam syllabus and your exam marks. Prepare everything from the book, prepare all the inside question, exercise question, everything. Since it will be an MCQ type question, you don't have to write the answer, but you just have to click on the right option. Okay, 4 options will be there. You have to click on the right option. So, you can imagine how easy it's going to be. I expect all of you will get 20 on 20 because the answers are very easy. Questions are all from the book and very simple. Okay. So, come to exercise number A of nouns chapter. Dhoni, proper noun. Batsman, common noun. Knowledge, abstract noun. Cricket, common noun. Ravi, proper noun. Man, common noun. Wisdom, abstract noun. Where you will find the link? I think in your e-portal. Okay. It will be informed to you. Number 4, desert, common noun. Sugar, milk, honey, all 3 are material noun. Number 5, herd, collective noun. Cattle can either be a common noun or a collective noun in itself. So, you can write common noun for cattle. Farmer, common noun. Backyard, common noun. Okay. So, I don't think any more confusion is there. Any confusion, Anisha? Did you get it? The answers which I said just now? Cricket, proper noun. No, it is not given in capital letter. Sometimes the name of the name of certain kind of sports can be written as proper noun, but here it will be common noun. Okay. Anything else? Any other questions you have? Yes, syllabus you can revise. All the question answers, do it. Question answers from inside the book, try to take out, make open your books, reader books, read everything carefully, try to find out what questions can come from them. Simple questions will be asked, but they will be from the chapters itself. Okay, so read everything properly. Okay, thank you students. Even if you have more doubts, you can always ask me in the by mailing it to me, or you can ask me in the e-portal if it is working. You will ask questions. I don't think we have time left today to ask you questions. Yes, read word meanings also. Word meanings which are mentioned in the book, read them only. Nothing to do from outside. If the word meanings are written in the book, those word meanings only you will do. No, just MCQ questions will be given. You have to click on the right option. Okay, the format will be given. 4 options will be there. You have to click on the right option. Any other problem, students? It will be a very simple exam, very easy questions have been set, because this is the first time you are doing an online exam. So I hope all of you will be able to do it honestly, sincerely. Okay, thank you students.